Running up.
And we coming in live.
Yo.
What's
good, man?
What's good, brother? Yo, I miss you, man.
I miss you too, bro.
I miss you, yo. It's been a minute, man.
It's been a minute, bro. Yeah. I'm talking about a minute.
Yeah.
Now, I know niggas been planning shit to, like, film this shit and shit, but...
Listen, man.
Schedules don't meet.
Yeah, for sure. For sure. I mean, we got our own lives and stuff, so...
Nah, I'm playing. But, yeah, bro, I've been, you know, I just got back from Miami and shit.
Subtle flex. I just got back from Miami, bro. Little sun.
Little getaway vacation, nothing crazy, you know what I mean? Nah, but yeah, bro, Miami was fun. I had a blast. I was we're very good people. And I'm back here, and it's back to work, so.
Yeah, bro. I'm not going to lie, man, like, of course, like we haven't been putting out, episode. But rest assured, y'all, we've been working. If you haven't noticed already from our intro,
how y'all like that?
We've been working. You know what I mean? We've been working. So yeah, bro. Do you want to like? That's one part of the good news we have for this podcast. Cause I figure episode 5, we need some. We need something to celebrate about.
Oh, of course.
We need something to come back with. We've been breaking our promise, trying to give y'all every other week, but we was working. You want to give the other piece of a surprising?
Yeah,
surprise.
I got you.
Episode 5.
As you know, we definitely started off this podcast with just ideas and everything, and we started off with just YouTube and just promoted on YouTube, but you know, I know, like, sometimes podcasts, you don't want to watch it, you just want to hear it. So,
yeah.
MiDNiGHT CaST is now on all platforms, iTunes, Spotify, and everything. So, we made that happen for you guys. And so I'm excited, man. I'm pumped for that shit, yeah, bro.
So, like, from now on,
y'all can go on iTunes and Spotify, whatever the fuck y'all niggas use, man. And it's going to be there. We're going to be there.
AKA,
yeah, you working, you know, you can't really, you can't.
AKA, it's no excuses now.
No excuses now. Nah.
Oh, you don't got a YouTube account. Nah, oh, check this shit out. Open your podcast app.
Right.
Now, me, type us in.
Right.
And you don't got to pay for it.
Right.
You ain't need nothing, bro. All you need is an iPod.
All you got to say is you don't got to pay for it.
Yeah.
And it's free.
It's free, dog.
You feel me? You working. I know you can't watch it, but you can listen. So
you got that Spotify. You got the free account. Mm-hmm. Still works on the free account, dog.
Work on the free account. For sure.
So, yeah. You know what I mean? Go watch that. We up there. Our old videos are up there if y'all didn't see them already.
Right.
But we officially...
We out here.
Out here.
Yeah.
On
officially,
all platforms.
Officially.
Yeah. So, that shit made me happy.
Yeah. What's good with you, though, man? How you been?
Well, you've been living up in Miami. Yeah, I've been kind of hitting a rut. I mean, it's real, dog. If y'all didn't know, Miguel went on a little spiritual hiatus in his journey. A couple weeks ago.
I still recommend people to at least take 1 month.
Yeah.
And just take that spiritual journey. It's good for your health.
It is. And I was there to witness his. And right when he finished his, I just got hit with some like spiritual journey. You kind of get called to it. I'm not going to lie. You kind of get called to it. Like, I just been feeling like stressed, bro. Like stressed and like frustrated. And one day I just caught myself in some anger. Like out of nowhere, bro. Like my life is good. Like.
Yeah.
You know, somebody pressed me and I was getting ready like I didn't feel that, like, in a while, bro. Yeah. Like, I was about to unleash Bronx out here, yo. And I'm like, yo, I can't, yo, I gotta stop. You know what I mean? Like,
he said, yo, 170.
Yeah, bro. I'm like, yo, you know, 7718, bro. I was like, yo, press me. Yeah.
No, nigga. Right. Nobody pressing me saying 718, nigga.
Yo,
somebody
that's
say
shit,
718.
Yo. That's old
I'm
shit.
I'm not taking you serious, nigga.
Yeah, no way.
Yo, 718, nigga.
Nah. Don't ever scream that when you're trying to. Don't ever do that.
I feel like niggas from Philly do that shit.
Really?
Yeah. They do that shit.
Like, that's weak shit.
Niggas from
that's weak
shit. Like, niggas from Philly, like, tap their fucking, like, area code.
Listen, yo, if you haven't noticed already, we from New York. This is a New York podcast, so everybody who's listening from not New York,
I don't care.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry, yo. That's some weak shit. Don't ever yell your area code.
It is.
There's no landlines anymore, so there's no point to be yelling your area code no more, yo. Jeez. Niggas have like
that shit is area not scary at all.
Nah,
bro.
Nah, no way.
That shit is
I don't want
to not intimidate me.
You know what though? Like, I don't want anybody yelling anything at me when I'm hitting the fade. I don't.
Yeah,
don't throw a fade at me when you're trying to. That's weird in general, bro. Like, I don't want to. Just throw the fade. If you yell at something, I'm throwing it first.
Yeah.
How about that?
Yeah.
How about that? Shut that shit up real quick.
I'm dead.
But nah, bro. Anyway, that was a tangent. But yeah, man. Like I got angry, bro. Like out of nowhere, and I just had to pull back. Like. Listen, man, my life is good right now. I can't. There's no point, yo. You know what I mean? Getting angry over small shit. So, the book he was reading, it was, what is it called?
It's called Buddha's Brain.
That's right. It's called Buddha's Brain. I actually bought that a couple of days ago, and I'm about to start my own spiritual journey and just trying to find
that,
some.
Bro. Good luck with that, bro.
Yeah. I'm reading all types of shit, man. I'm reading that book. I'm reading Tibetan Book of the Dead. Completely, because I started reading it before, but I just stopped once I found, and I thought that was fucked up. Like, I thought it was, like, I should read the whole book.
Yeah.
So I bought that, and I bought this philosophy book just to read about ideas and shit. And, oh, my creative book, because I felt like I was getting a creative rut, too. I don't know if it was because I was stressed or whatever, but my creativity kind of went down. I was like, fuck, man. Like,
yeah. Do you think people take books serious anymore? Because now it's like they don't get like the physical copy or anything like that.
I think people who read books now just read it for some sort of answers. They don't read it for pure enjoyment. Like, they don't read it just to learn, yo. Because I think, and this is my own like philosophy on books, like the educational system fucks that up. Like, the fact, and I mean, I, yo, y'all teachers
the
out
education
there.
Is just, the education system fucks a lot of things up.
Yeah, y'all teachers out there, I know y'all mean well, man, and I know y'all want to give kids, like, you know, summer books to read, but goddamn, that just enjoys the shit out of reading later. Like, it just takes the fun out of it, man. And it takes so many years to get back and be like, yo, pick up a book and not feel like it's, like, labor.
Yeah. Because when I was young, people would tell me, read a book. And I'm like, nah, I'm about to go bump
this
music real quick. I don't give a fuck about a book.
Oh, I wonder, bro.
Now it's like, nah, nigga, like, I want to read books. Like, it's crazy how, like, now that you're older, it's like you're starting to appreciate books. But it's still, like I said, though, it's still some people that don't really appreciate books.
No, and I think, too, like, nowadays, I mean, I'm not speaking for everybody, but, like, some people, when they read books, like, it's for, like, the social media.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, it's for social media. Like, don't read a chapter and then...
Yeah, and then, like, post, I'm reading.
You know, reading. This is so deep.
Reading. Take a picture of the book.
By the pool. You know what I'm saying? Like, yo, like, all
in
right,
in Central
man,
Park,
man,
you right. On the grass and shit.
Finish the book.
Nah. Finish the book.
Finish it, okay? No, finish. Put the phone down and finish it. All right. I don't want no pictures of pages being read or chapters being read.
Posting pages and shit. Like,
next time anybody posts a picture that I'm reading, I'm checking the page number.
Yeah.
If that shit don't say 100 and something,
you're not reading it.
You're not reading it, bro. And don't flip. Don't put 200 and something in picture and post it. No, you're not reading it. Finish the book. I encourage everybody to finish it, because you know what? That's character, bro. When you can start something and finish it, that's big.
Yeah, that's big. That's big. That's very big.
I encourage everybody, when you ever start reading a book, finish it.
Yeah.
It's worth it. It's worth it in the end.
Goes with the same way with sex, you know? Finish it.
Oh, man, yo. Episode 5, everyone. Finish it. Welcome to episode 5. I'm your boy, Joe, back here. This is... Yeah, boy. I don't...
Nah, all jokes, man. It's Jiggy, you know, here, co-host, whatever you want to call me.
Co-host. Come on, man. Biggie. You're too humble sometimes, man. You're too humble. Co-host, bro. You kidding me?
I like co-host.
Nah, co-host means you sidekick. No, I'm not letting you get away with that, bro, okay?
Does that mean I'm like Robin or something?
Yes, bro. That means I'm Batman.
Okay, Robin was cool, though. Robin was cool, though. He was cool.
This is what we're going to start with. Yo, this is the only podcast.
I ain't gonna lie, Batman was gangster, though.
Listen, man. This is the only podcast that you can get a segue from sex to Batman. This is the only one.
Yeah, I think so.
All right, just so y'all know.
Definitely think so.
Whenever you doubt
All I just podcast, said was finish sex.
Yo, whenever you doubt listening to this podcast, just know we got that on you. We could do that.
Yeah.
All right? Anyway, Batman. Batman was badass, bro. No, Batman was
Batman
badass.
Batman was gangster. He had the hoes and he had money and all that. Not the hoes, but you know, he had women.
He had though.
He had a lot of women.
He had though. Yeah, he did. But then when...
cars, gadgets.
Yeah, but then when Robin came along, bro, it was like my man had a son.
And then yeah, but Robin wanted to be Batman.
Yeah, but he never did. This is what I'm saying, bro. Don't Robin yourself.
He had the potential to be Batman.
Nah, don't Robin yourself, son. The way I see it, we like, I don't know, bro. We like Cheech and Chong, like, you know what I mean?
Like that
dynamic. We like Dre and Snoop. That's a better dynamic to us, man.
Okay, Dre and Snoop.
In fact, that's a great dynamic. We are like Dre and Snoop. I'm with the boards and shit.
Yeah, then
you out here like...
One,
with
two,
the vibe. Yeah. That's we're Dre and Snoop, bro. Don't sidekick yourself.
I don't know. I thought Robin was pretty cool. But anyways...
Took a dive, bro. Twice.
Nah, but anyways... Yeah, guys, episode 5, pretty pumped.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to go straight into it, man.
I kind of want to start this shit off real quick, at least for the first.
We're going to go straight into it.
We definitely got to get when they see us out of the way.
Yeah.
Not out of the way, but just.
Nah, I definitely want to touch on that first.
Because, you know. We need to get that out.
When it released. We still was promoting episode 4, so we didn't even get a chance to...
Yeah, that's right, 5. Yeah. When it released, we were kind of promoting episode 4. It was already shot, so we couldn't really say anything. I hate when that happens.
Yeah, it sucks, but we hit, man. We got it. So,
yeah.
When they see us, if you guys haven't seen it yet, I still recommend you guys to go see it. It's on Netflix. It's a little documentary about the Central Park 5.
It's like a series. It's like a kind of reenactment.
Yeah, docu-series.
Yeah.
About the Central Park 5. And how, like, you know, these guys got convicted of something they didn't do and they really served time in jail. And it was very wrong and awful. And I think, like, I'm so grateful for that documentary, bro, because it, like, introduced this case to people that never heard it before. Like, this was the first time they heard it before. And, like, I remember my mom telling me about it back in, like, I think, like, 2011, because it was on the news. I think they were just coming out of jail around that time, and they was going to film a movie. They announced it, like, years ago, but it ended up being a docuseries. So I was very excited about that, bro, like, just for that, making that, and, like, they really dug into, like, the information and, like, how it really happened and how they, like, really told you know what I'm saying? Like, how they have the actual video of them, like, of the cops interrogating them. And tell them, but, you know what I'm saying? Like, the evidence is all right there, like, and it's crazy. Like, like, they really, like, try to get, they really try to, like, pin the how you call it?
Yeah, like, the blame.
The blame on them. Like, they really try to, like,
get
it on them, bro. Yeah, like, they just needed something to
stick.
Yeah. And it sucks, bro. The criminal justice system is, like, the most corrupted thing in the world, bro, to me. It sucks, bro. Like, I don't know. Like, it's just whack, my nigga. Like,
I didn't know about this case until you told me about it. And you were like, yo, you got to watch this series and whatnot. You got to watch the series. It has to do with New York, bro. And it'd be great for our New York podcast. Like, we got to talk about it.
For sure.
We wouldn't be doing New York justice if we didn't talk about it. And I was like, all right, bro. Like, want me to do it? I'll watch it, right? I'm like, all right, I'll watch it.
Yeah.
So I just threw it on. I had no idea what it was about. You told me about, like, these kids that were set up by the cops or whatever, and they had to do jail time. So I didn't think anything of it. When I watched it, man.
Bro, tell me you ain't cry, bro.
Yeah. This is for the listeners that are, you know, obviously, you know, listening to this, but I encourage everybody to watch that series, man. That series is deep and
very
and heartfelt. And when I watched it, man, it was hard to watch, man. From the very first episode, and I told my dad this because I asked him, like, if he saw it, and he was like, "Nah, I haven't seen it yet." He was like, "But how is it?" I was like, "The only way I could describe it, yo, is like in the beginning." Like, as soon as it starts off, they put their foot on your neck, bro. It's like, hold that, bro. Like, hold that shit, and they don't let go. They don't let go for all four episodes. Like, they just put your foot on your neck, and they don't let you breathe until the very, like, last 10 minutes of the film. And you finally, like, feel like you can exhale. Like, you just... Damn, like, all of that, like, shit, like, and it just gets harder and harder as you watch, but in my head, man, like, that shit hit, I don't know why, man, but that shit hit hard for me, because I'm writing a script similar to that, or, like, dealing with, like, that type of thing, and I wrote my script based off of, you know, like, New York stories, like New York kids that I grew up with that told me their experiences or experiences that I like had like in my youth or whatever. And I wrote that script based off on that. And it was almost like I was writing like the stories that my friends would tell me so that hopefully it could be shared to the world. It could come alive, like, for everybody else to see. Because people don't talk about that shit. Even the people that go through it, they don't talk about that shit.
Nah, man, shit. It's either that or it doesn't get the attention that
it should. Yeah, it doesn't reach far. So, you know, for me, as a story writer, as a person that wants to do film, it's like I'm almost obligated to make these stories known, bro.
Mm-hmm.
And, like, this story, to me, it hit like that.
Yeah.
It was, like, for these kids that just grew up in Harlem, and nobody gave a shit.
Yeah.
It was wild, bro. It was really wild, and that hit me, like, as if it was... I could relate to it, bro. I could relate to it. And I was that kid, bro. Not in Harlem, but East Harlem. I was like that, hanging out with my friends.
Could have been anybody, bro.
That's what killed me, man.
Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, they're like, what, 12, 13? And y'all really trying to pin this...
It was...
On these young kids, like...
Yeah.
It's sick, bro. It's sick. It's just sick. It's a sick corruption, bro. Like, I always say that. Like, the criminal justice system is like... the most corrupted system, bro. Like, and I don't know, bro.
Everybody, I push everybody to watch that. Everybody should watch it, no matter what skin color you are, no matter what job you have. If you're a teacher, watch it. If you're a cop, watch it. If you know what I mean, like everybody should watch, because it's like such a humanistic film that just brings out the human in you, bro. Yeah. It just brings out that quality, like fuck, like we should all band together and be more better human beings, man. Like
sure,
that,
for sure, bro. When the cop hit the boy with that helmet, bro. Oh, man. Bro, that's what I'm like, nah. It's over. I know what I'm in for now.
I didn't even like. When they tried to spin it, like, where'd you get that?
Yeah. Oh, I got scratched. It's not a scratch, bro.
Yeah.
He's
like
shaking, like he.
Yeah, man. Can't talk, like, there's a lot of shit in there, man. They tried to spin it out as if like the dude got hit by the cop's helmet. He got hit because the lady was fighting him.
Yeah. Supposedly, like, because she was, like, resisting.
She was resisting or whatnot. Yeah, like, it was wild. And I don't want to ruin the complete story part, because I think Jiggy summed it up pretty well.
Yeah.
But, you know, I don't want to take away from anything else that you guys might watch and find. So, I'm going to leave it like that. Just watch it.
Just watch it. Yo, and shout out to Jarrell, man.
Yeah.
For real.
That
nigga deserve an Oscar for that shit.
Yeah. And you know what's crazy? I loved it so much that I went and saw, like, I guess Oprah did, like, interview with the cast. And she did an interview with the actual people. Man, I just skipped to the people, honestly. Yeah, I was like, yo, I could watch the cast and all that later and, like, see whatever background, you know, thing that they could go. I just skipped to the people because I really wanted that real. You know what I mean? Man, they were so fucked up, bro.
Yeah.
They were so fucked up. But I understand, man. Like, the guy who, like, his father did what he did. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I don't want to say
it for the listeners. I know what you mean, yeah.
Like, that, he never forgave his father from that,
bro.
That's
real
never shit. Forgave his father
that's
from that.
That's real shit, though.
And the dude who went to prison at the age of 16, man, you could tell, man. You could tell by his face, like, he's fucked up, bro. Yeah. He's fucked up.
Yeah.
But, yeah, man. But watch that.
Shout out to those guys, though, man. You guys are...
All of y'all need an Oscar, man, or Emmy, or whatever, man. Because that...
all of y'all. And shout out to the real ones, too. The real Central Park Five. Y'all guys are...
You guys are heroes, man.
Y'all heroes, man, for sure.
You guys are heroes.
For sure.
And we all love you. And everybody that watched that Netflix show.
I'm pretty sure everybody loves you guys, man.
Yeah.
For real.
Yeah, man. But, yeah, man, going off of that.
Yeah, man.
You want to talk about this Future album, man?
Yo, man.
Speaking of things that we love.
He's been trying to get me... talk about this damn Future album.
Yo. Listen.
I don't want to talk about it, Joe.
Listen, man. Listen, yo.
Look. I don't want to talk about it, bro.
Listen, yo. I'm looking at the clock before we break.
Nah, we can get it.
You got 5 minutes,
we can get
bro.
To Future.
I think
we can get it to Future. We get to Future real quick. Yo, Future, that album was whack. All right, we out.
Wow.
We out.
Yeah? That's it?
That shit was trash, bro.
I could have waited 30 seconds for that.
That shit was fucking whack, my nigga.
Wow. You don't want to elaborate?
That shit
or
was
just...
fucking whack.
Yeah?
That shit was whack. That shit was whack.
Wow. This is wild. You didn't even like one song on here? Not one?
Nah, bro.
Not one. Mm-mm. You didn't like Shotgun?
No.
No Xanax Damage? Wow, man.
Let me see.
Crazy. Yeah, I mean, take a look at that.
Yeah,
no, take a look at that, yo. Like before this, just jump
one
off
song
the ship, bro.
I might be over exaggerating.
Jump off the ship, man. It's like, yo, Future, this is trash, bro. Complete trash.
Nah.
No, that wasn't it. Last one. You might like the last one. That was trash too.
Yeah, love Diana.
Yeah, I know.
That's it.
That's it. Love Diana. That's it.
That's the only valid song you got on that, bro.
I
needed those songs on that, bro.
I'm gonna come clean. I don't like that album either. I don't like that album either. I hate it. I like two tracks off of it. Two and a half. Mm-hmm. I like Shotgun, even though Shotgun sounds like another song. But I like Shotgun. I like Love Thy Enemies and Xanax Damage occasionally. So okay. Xanax Damage, yo, he sounds like Vibes Cartel when he slows down his voice. And I never realized that till he slowed down his voice. I'm like, yo, this dude sounds like Vibes, except he's not Vibes.
He's not the vibe right now.
Nah, he's not Vibes, yo. Like,
yo, man, I don't know, bro. Like,
all right, man. So we both hate the album. Is that it?
I hate it, bro, because it's like, okay, what was the other singing album he had?
That was fire.
Hendrix,
was fire.
Of course, Hendrix was beautiful. Right. It's a beautiful album.
I'm like, yo, I was about to fight, bro.
It's a beautiful album. It's a beautiful album. So when he was coming out with this,
you got hype.
He said that. He said it was like a Hendrix type of vibe.
Yeah, he did. He definitely did.
So I was like, all right. Cool. I ain't like it, man. I ain't like it at all, bro. That wasn't Hendrix, man.
Go back. Go redo it.
That was a Hendrix, man.
Redo it. Redo Save Me.
That was a Hendrix, man.
I'm going to save you. I'm going to save you the time.
That wasn't Hendrix, bro. I don't know, bro. Like, Future to me is like, I feel like he already done what he done.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
Oh, shit. I see where this is going.
Like, he's...
Chalk it up?
Nah.
Take a break.
No. Don't take a break. It's just...
Do a spiritual journey. Find yourself. If you're coming out with an album called Save Me, you should probably take a spiritual journey. Okay? All right. And that shit sounds like shit, dog.
Yeah.
I think you might need a break.
See, with Future, is like, even the last album that he dropped, people wasn't really fucking with
it
either.
It wasn't that. It was a slow burn.
I liked it a little bit.
I had to warm up to it.
But even that, I feel like people was just like not excited about Future no more. To me.
I agree. I think his music is slowly becoming outdated. I think that's what it is.
Like he's burning himself. Like he burnt himself out.
I think he sold his like music cadence or like the way he does his music so much that like it hasn't evolved. Yeah, like it hasn't evolved. There's never been like a song that doesn't sound like Future that he's made.
Right.
Other than Hendrix. Hendrix was like the farthest he went.
That's when it was like, oh shit, Future. Oh,
yeah. Hendrix
everybody
was like
talking about Future on that one. On that run.
Yeah,
like, that nigga made an R&B album. That's crazy.
Yeah, but that was the one time he ever stepped out of his shit, and it was fire. But because I'm thinking, like, who was the person that was successful in like that whole the way they made their sound for so long? And I can think of Drake.
Yeah.
But even he switched it up with like, are you reading this? And like, and even to that, I'm not gonna lie, bro. Like, I'm not gonna lie. Some of it is still repetitive to me.
Yeah, I mean, like, same thing with Future. Future
like the way
shit.
I felt with Wizard is probably the way I felt with Views. Like it reached its plateau, dog. Like you reached the point where it's your sound just sounds like you, and it's not. It doesn't hit like that anymore.
Yeah.
But, yeah, man, Future, dog. No, Save Me. Yeah, need some saving, bro. That take a spiritual journey.
I know there's another album coming out.
I don't know if I want it. I don't know if I want it. Don't throw it out. Don't put it out. Save it. Save me the time, bro. How about that? Save me the time of listening to the next album and take a spiritual journey, all right? Take 2 years, bro. Take 2 years for yourself. I think you need it. You know what I mean?
He took a while already. He took his little thing, and then he came out with Crushed Up. I like that song.
Crushed Up is good. Like I said, I think I like Wizard. Wizard was a slow burn, though. It didn't hit like it was like DS2.
Oh, nah.
It didn't hit that way. Nah, like, when I first heard DS2, it was like, whoa.
Yeah, DS2 hit different.
Yeah. I think Future should not... Don't give me another album. Just take two years, bro. I don't need to hear Future anymore. Not anymore, but like...
For now, he's saying.
For now. I don't need to know. No. But speaking about doubling back and all of that, what do you think about Drake's his little 2 EP? It's like a 2-track EP, right? Would you say that? 2-track EP?
I mean, it's 2 songs, right? I mean,
yeah, but he like put it out like a bundle, like as if it was like an EP, so I'm treating it like, yo, is this an EP?
Drake is just going to do Drake things, bro.
Yeah, this is true.
This is Drake, bro.
I mean...
We never know what it means. We just go with it. We never question the man.
Yeah. I mean, by now it's like, I don't want to dick ride Drake, but... I mean, by now it's like, fam, we just accept whatever he gives us.
Oh,
man.
Of course. It's Drake.
He's earned that. That's what I'm saying. Like, he's earned that.
I love the 2 songs, actually.
Yeah?
It's a
Omerta and...
Money in the Grave.
Money in the Grave.
I love it, bro. I love Money in the Grave, but... both songs are good. Both songs are good, but I think those was like throwaways type shit.
I think so too.
Because like,
I think so.
You know, his team, you know, the Raptors, they was in the championship. So they was like, so he was saying if they win, he'll drop 2 new songs. People's going hard because like they saying, oh, you not giving the winning energy. He's supposed to make a song for the Raptors. And
I don't want that.
Nigga, he said he was going to drop 2 songs.
Yeah.
Not 2 songs. 2 songs about
the Raptors.
Yeah,
bro.
Nigga.
No.
Like, no. He said he's going to give us 2 songs, nigga.
No, I don't want 2 songs about the Raptors, bro. No, I don't care that much about the Raptors, yo. Like, no.
I'm glad
he came out.
I mean, a little Raptors anthem will be fire, though.
I'm cool. Look,
like, it would have been fire if he dropped it in the middle of them, like,
yeah,
in the playoffs.
In the whole playoffs coming up, yeah.
That dropped, would be cool. Like, a Raptors song in the middle of that, fire. Because then that could use
be. That, yeah, that could be, yeah.
They'll play that when they come out and shit. That's heat. Yeah. That's fire.
This is true. This is true.
That's fire. But, yeah, man, he didn't say he was going to make...
Yeah, nah, I don't.
A finals song, like...
I don't want it. I'm glad with what I got. I agree with you that there's throwaways. It's good.
It's good songs though.
Yeah, it's good. It's good for me. It's good. Yo, nigga, stop as soon as it out. Yo, you ain't speaking for me. Well, hold on. All right, it's good for me, bro. It's good for me, but I don't think I'm sticking with it for too long, yo. Like, I don't think that's enough for me to hold like the summer over, or whatever. And they're not really summer songs, so it's
the
like,
Omerta song.
Nah.
What you think about that one?
All right, this is how I rank it. If I gotta rank it, I think Money in the Grave bangs harder than Omerta. Point blank.
Obvious.
Omerta is like him just spitting out bars, and I like that. It's cool. It's cool. It's cool.
I mean,
it don't really do much to me. I get the bars that's being said, but it don't do much. Like, it don't really do much to me. Yeah. Money in the Grave to me bangs a little harder, and Ross's joint is good. And I'm sure he put that out because maybe Ross is coming out with an album soon. So
I heard the Ross verse was late.
It was late.
Yeah,
cause he's working on his album, bro.
I'm not excited for a Ross album.
You not excited for the Ross album? I was until I heard the song, and I'm like, all right, nigga, I could wait. I could wait.
I mean, I
could wait.
At this point, I love Rick Ross. Don't get me wrong.
I like his smooth shit.
I like his some of his albums. God Forgives and I Don't. That's a good album.
Dog, that shit makes me feel like I'm rich in my whip, dog.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
That's how you're supposed to feel when you listen to Ross.
Yeah.
Like, I'm good on the Ross album, bro.
I don't want this Ross album. I know what this Ross album is,
and
I don't want
know
it.
What it is, and I'm good on it. I'm good on the Lost album.
Yeah, I think I might pass on that shit
I'm
too.
I'm good.
Speaking of OGs though, did you listen to Jim Jones's album?
I'm good on Jim Jones.
Wow.
I'm good on Jim Jones' album.
Wow, son.
I'm good.
Interesting.
I'm good.
What and you got? Harlem, that's
he
crazy.
He got.
You niggas would have thought at least, you know, niggas
stay
from
fly
Harlem.
Part 2 on that.
Whoa, shit. Yo, what a disrespect, son. He said we stay fly Part 2.
You know what I mean?
Wow. So, I'm not going to lie, bro. I'm not going to lie. I was reluctant on hearing this album, too. But it's fire. Not going to lie. It's fire.
It's fire.
I know that sounds crazy from a Jim Jones album. But it's fire.
No, because Jim Jones has one fire album, but...
Yes, he does. And I agree with that. This is the second fire album.
Oh, okay.
No, I agree with you. I know what you're saying, yo. Yeah, I know what you're saying. Like, Jim Jones not the nigga to be like, yo...
Yeah, yo, that Jim Jones album, son.
Yeah, he's not that nigga to run to the album with. But I just listened to it because I was like, yo, you know, let me check out... This nigga, because I haven't heard his shit in that long, and I wasn't disappointed, bro.
About Jim Jones.
I wasn't disappointed.
I ain't gonna lie. How about this?
I was surprised at how good it was. There you go. That's my critique. I was surprised on how good it was.
Okay, so now I gotta listen to it. But I ain't gonna lie. I'm not gonna. Jim Jones, my man's, though. He from Harlem. You know?
Yeah, okay.
Harlem niggas gotta.
Okay.
You feel me? For me, it's just that Jones.
It took a Bronx nigga to be like, yo, listen to Jim Jones. This is crazy.
You go to Harlem, bro. Nobody really saying Jim Jones.
You right. Yeah, no more. Not anymore. Like, not anymore. Yeah, them days is over, yo.
Them days is over. Yeah. They put Harlem on the map. They were well respected.
Yeah,
Dipset
sure.
And all of them. They put where I'm from on the map. And I'm highly respected. Thank you. I appreciate it. No more, though. I'm good on the
In other words, album, Jim though. Jones, don't bring your Lambo to Harlem. We don't want it.
We don't want your Lambo in Harlem.
People gonna treat you like regular shit, dog. Okay.
Nah, but I'm gonna try to bump to that album.
Just listen to it, bro. You don't gotta bump it. You don't gotta bump it. Just listen to it and let me know how you feel.
I'm gonna try to listen to
it. I think you'll be surprised because I was surprised and I was like, oh shit, this is actually. Good, like it's not even bad, it's good.
Okay.
So
I know if Jim Jones hear this, he'll be in his feelings. Like he's gonna come at me the most.
Yeah, right. Yo,
it's the slow
wow.
Nigga right here, yo,
listen, it was a good job, bro. That was a good album. Good job.
Right,
pat on the back. All
right.
Yeah.
I gotta listen to that Jones album. He had Cam on it.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, everybody on this.
Yeah.
Fat Joe, Remy Ma.
Not Remy Ma. Yeah, Fat Joe, Cam on like 2 tracks. One track is fire. Fab. You got Fab on there.
Got Fab. Okay.
That's
another nigga I'm good on.
Full of OGs. Oh yeah, I think I'm about to skip out on Summertime Shootout 3. I'm good, bro. Yeah, I'm good, bro.
That's another nigga that's just like Summertime.
Yeah. Like.
Part 3? I didn't even know he came out with 2. No funny shit.
1 was cool. 3 was
bad.
I didn't even know he
came out with a second one. Now he's coming out with 3.
3 was 2 was bad.
Listen, let me tell you the last Fabulous album project I heard. That's crazy how I gotta think about this.
Please don't say no competition.
No, you wildin'. That was probably like his best work.
No, of course.
There's no competition too.
And what's wild is that it was a mixtape, much like Drake.
Crazy. But I think the Young OG shit was the last shit I heard.
That's sad. Actually, no, that's not sad. Well, it is sad because that's a sad ending, but.
The Young OG, that was the last shit I heard.
That hurts. Young OG was disappointing. Yeah. That shit was disappointing.
That shit was whack.
I don't give a fuck who says otherwise.
And then after that,
that was a bad album.
Like,
that was a bad album.
I was just like, yeah, I'm kind of done with you, Fab.
I think he knew that shit. That's why he fell back.
Yeah.
He's like, I'm gonna try this mixtape shit again, and he's you know striking out on that shit.
Oh, Soul Tapes was good too.
No, Soul Tapes was great.
Soul Tapes was great. What is it? One, two,
and three.
And three.
Both.
Yo,
of them.
All
he
the
came
OG
with
it. Was great.
Great.
That was a great trilogy right there.
All three, yeah.
That was a great trilogy.
And then it was a nosedive. He was supposed to come out with Loso 2, and I was ramped up because Loso 1 was fire. Loso's way was fire, and he was going to come out with 2, and he never came out with 2. And then I just feel like, you know, that Fab was gone, bro.
Yeah. I'm good with Fab, too. But,
yeah.
It is what it is.
Well,
man.
Speaking on OGs, right? Did you get a chance to hear that Dreamville shit?
Dreamville? Whoa. You said speaking of OGs.
Yeah, yo. So J. Cole not an OG now? We can talk about that. J. Cole treating these niggas like he's an OG now. Come on, man.
I think Drake's an OG now, too. Drake is an OG.
No. There you go.
This shit is hard. This is harder than I expected. Okay, so what do we consider an OG?
Person that's been in the game for a long time.
Right. So, but like a person who's retired from the game or a person who's still in the game?
Still active.
That's like...
I mean, it could go either way, but most of the time, nowadays, it's people who are still active. Jay-Z still active?
Jay-Z's an OG. But Jay-Z been rapping since like the 80s, 89.
And he's still active. And he's the OG of the OGs now.
Yeah.
But like, he's still active.
To me, Cole's not an OG.
Why is that? How many albums he got behind him now? So like 4 or 5 now? 5. Shall we count?
Yeah,
Sideline Story.
1.
Born Center.
2.
The shit everybody heralds as his great album.
Forest Hills.
Then he got the one that everybody killed him for. Letter. For Your Eyes Only. For Your Eyes Only. That was his 4th. And then 5. K.O.D.
Which is the...
5 albums under his belt. Yeah. Drake got...
Take Care.
Thank Me Later.
Take Care. Nothing Was the Same.
Views. And...
More Life
does not count.
What? More Life counts as an album.
More Life does not count as an album. We're not doing this again, man. We're not doing this again, yo. More Life do not count.
That counts, bro. It counts.
Are you kidding me?
It counts.
He even said it don't count.
What the fuck would he say? It counts a fucking album.
And then Scorpion. Said it was a playlist.
6.
All right, fine.
Oh, my nigga. Who is he to say, no, that's not an album?
Either way. Check this shit out. Either way. He on 6. J. Cole's on 5. Come on.
Okay. J. Cole's an OG.
Give it to me, man. I know that sounds crazy with the transition, but he's the OG now.
Okay, so me admitting that J. Cole's an OG.
Okay.
Meaning I've been listening to that nigga
for a while, bro. For a while.
That's insane.
Listen, man, when you can go around act looking bummy and still get respect, I think you're an OG now.
Yeah.
I think you're an OG now. Kanye does it. Jay-Z does it.
Yeah.
I think you could call him an OG now, son.
You're right, bro.
Like,
most definitely.
Kendrick does it. What's up? See, that's another thing, son. What's up with y'all niggas now? All of a sudden, y'all got like this high status and y'all want to go reverse. Like, yo, I'm going to just start dressing like I was in my basement now. You know what I mean? Like, what's up with that? Going backward. It's cool, though.
It's a lot of people out here that. When I was in Miami, bro, it was a lot of people that couldn't dress.
Yeah? Really?
I seen like a dude with like jeans and water shoes on. Yeah, don't ask me why, bro. I kid you not, he had water shoes on, bro. With jeans. And they were baggy.
And it was, people was rocking it like that? Like people were looking at it like this nigga like, yo.
Just walking.
Wow.
It's like weirdos in Miami, bro. Like, you know, they all look crazy. Like they don't, like some of the weirdos be looking like I think like bath salt is real out there. No joke.
I've heard that Florida's crazy. Like I've heard niggas in Florida are crazy.
It's a bunch of weirdos out there, bro.
But
it's dope though. Just a couple weirdos.
You can't shit on niggas and say it's dope now.
I can. Who am I not to say?
All right. Hey, man. All right.
Cool. I said some people. I ain't say Miami was the fucking capital of bath salt. I didn't say that.
All right. Fair enough, man. Gotta clear it up, bro. Hey. Gotta clear it up. No, it's funny you say that. That's shocking to me because I've never been at Miami, but I always want to. And I always thought Miami was fire, son. Like, the vibes, the people dressing and all that. But I guess not. It's fire,
but niggas really can't dress, bro.
Wow.
Niggas really can't dress. I mean, I guess it's like, because it's so hot out there, you just wear cool clothes or whatever, like whatever. But come on, my nigga, you gonna wear jeans and
shoes. Didn't you say this shit about Cali, too?
Nah, Cali niggas could dress.
Oh, no, I got that from my other dude. He went to Cali and he was like, yo, niggas in Cali just dress like they mad lax.
Yeah, like flip-flops and fucking cargoes, fucking chino shorts and shit.
Cargoes or chinos?
Chino shorts.
Oh, I'm
chino
like, fam, niggas out in cargo shorts. That's crazy.
Chino shorts, flip-flops, white people type shit. So if you go to the hood, if you go to the hood, niggas be wearing jeans out there. And like...
In Cali?
Yeah. You go to the hood, niggas wear jeans, but that's because they got the grip on them.
Yeah. You can't wear chinos with the grip.
Yeah, you can't wear shorts with the grip.
Yeah, you can't. Yeah, you can't, bro. You can't hold that shit.
Mm-hmm. So.
That's funny, man.
But yeah, but it was cool, bro. Definitely cool.
All right, I'm going to take your word, man. Nobody in Miami got style. It's crazy.
Yeah, bro.
New York is west side.
Apparently. Even like the people that I was with. Like,
you seen that my style?
No. The people up, bro, when we was popping out to this shit, when we was going to like the clubs and shit,
yeah,
on the strip,
yeah,
everybody was grilling us for me.
Oh, cause
we was popping out.
Y'all was fresh.
Even though like it was girls with me.
Yeah,
like my friends that was with me. They was the one that was really like popping out for me.
Yeah.
So they was because they could dress. So.
Right.
We got the attention from me like now. These niggas.
What you came out with, man? I hope you didn't give him the Roscoe Waffle shirt.
Oh. I love that shirt, bro.
I know you do. That's why I asked, but I don't know if that's the shirt to go out with.
I love that shirt. Nah, bro. I had I was. Come on, bro. To me, I could have done better with my shits for me, but.
Mm-hmm.
I just like when I go out.
That's a
like,
topic right there, man. I always feel like no matter how fly you dress as a dude, when you're right next to a girl.
Nah, the girl, if I'm going out with a girl, the girl got to look better than me.
Oh, yeah, of course. But I'm saying, like, even if you try, bro. Yeah.
That's why I was, like, so hard for me to. It was so hard for me to dress up, bro, because the girls that I was with, they were looking great. They were looking so.
Yeah.
So it's like, I'm like, nah, I got to chill.
I think that's like, I don't know, man. Like, that's like dudes, like, I don't know. Like the way dudes dress.
But I take dressing
never
serious sometimes. Like, sometimes.
I mean, yeah, of course.
For me, like, but there'd be some days where it's just like, I could do better. You know what I'm saying?
I could do better.
Yeah. I mean, when I was down there, I bought out my South Beaches LeBrons.
Did you bring out your Nike? I don't know what those are, yo. Nah, those are Jordans. Those are Jordans because I saw the tag on it.
Which ones?
You always wear them, yo. It's like these high top Jordans, man.
Oh, yeah. Nah, not those.
Those are the go-tos, man.
I love those shoes.
What are they?
They're Jesters.
Jesters?
That's what they're called.
I've never seen them joints in my life. Only on you, bro.
Yeah, bro. People always stop me like, are those?
Where'd you even caught that?
Nike.
Where?
The Nike store.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow. That's crazy.
And then
I thought you would have bought like online or something like that.
And then I had the Sakai Blazers. The Blazers that I had.
Oh yeah. I remember that song.
Yeah. So but other than that, bro, you know.
Yo.
He was killing it out there.
Alright, man. That's good though. I mean, shit. If they can't dress, my nigga, teach them how to do it, you know what I mean?
Somebody got to.
Gotta teach them what to be.
But
yo.
I hear like they hate when New York people come over here.
They hate when New York people
go over there.
Cause we show up, boy.
That's exactly what the girl said.
Cause you show up, boy.
She said, you know, Miami people, us Miami people, well, she's like, they hate when you guys come over here because y'all bring that style and that.
That's so funny. I mean, you can't. What do you expect, yo?
The lifestyle out
that, here. No, it's funny.
I mean, but
it's
even some people out here that is just like, yo, y'all niggas can't dress.
Out here?
Yeah.
Really?
There's a lot of people. Not a lot.
That's because the bar so high. Here, like you just blend in here. Like you blend in here when you walk out.
My thing is like, I hate like when I see the potential that people could dress, but they still can't. They still dress.
I think it's effort though. Like you gotta put the effort in. If you don't want to put the effort in, no point. Yeah, it's like it's no point. And I think it's effort and it's confidence.
Yeah.
That go into it.
Yeah.
Like. If you don't want to put the effort because you don't really care that much, then it's like, all right, then you'll go half.
Yeah.
Halfway. Or like, if you don't have the confidence enough to do what you want to do because you feel like people won't understand it. I've seen that before, too.
True.
Like, people just won't. People going to judge you for, like, oh, why are you dressing like that? You don't dress like that before.
I'm not.
You know what I mean?
I'm not going to pull up
this
to them.
This for girls and guys, though.
I'm not going to go up to them like, I've yo, seen, why are you like, dressing like that?
Well, not you. I mean, not you. Like, you're obviously fashionista over here, yo. Like, you know what I mean?
Nah.
I'm not saying over here. Like, me too, but, like, me too. I can't, like, you know, I care about what I wear.
Yeah, I
get
what you mean.
Though. But it takes a certain kind of confidence, though. Yeah. Like, it takes a certain kind of confidence. Like, I remember, like, when I bought, like, because it's sort of, like, in fashion. Like, you see a lot of that shit in Soho. But, like, you know, people with, like, big pants. Like loose pants.
Oh yeah, the little spacious pants.
Yeah, like the spacious pants, whatever. And sometimes they roll it up or whatever. I was digging that shit like 2 years ago, and I saw it on the album of Toro y Ma. Like he was wearing them shits before like it kind of started getting popping. I was like, yo, that's fire. So I bought like the Dickie pants, yo. But it was like blue and green, and I wore them shits like you know like regular top or whatever, mad lax. It's like a lax kind of outfit. Yo, I got shit in on, bro. I got shit in on, man. But you got to expect these things because people see you a certain way and they get used to it. So when you switch it up, they be like, yo, what the fuck is you? Yo, I got shit in on by a girl. She was like, yo, what are you wearing? Like, you look like you got some pants that don't fit you, yo. Like not fit you like around the leg, like fit you lengthwise.
Yeah.
Like you, like your ankles is showing all out. It's crazy, yo. Like, what are you wearing? And I'm all like, ah, oh, man. And then I got the same shit from Kaiser, yo. Kaiser, like, yo, you look like you dressing like some sort of skater, but there's no skateboard. I'm like, damn, dog.
That is skater pants, though.
It is though. Yeah, it is though. But I don't know. I like the style, man. Sometimes I don't want to like really be wearing skinny pants like that. I like to switch it up. You know what I mean?
You guys like the style? Do it.
I'll That's what I'm saying. Yeah, I'll like, if you like something, do it, yo. Don't worry about what people are saying. Shit, sure, man. Fuck that.
I'm still going to say in my head, you know, like, man.
Yeah, but, like, do what you do, yo. You don't wear, the, you know, something extra loose. You don't wear it, bro. You don't wear something extra tight.
People come at me for wearing tight jeans, skinny jeans.
Really?
Yeah.
I never got that. I don't know why.
Yeah, bro. Like, when I was, like, first started it, like...
Oh, yeah. Oh, whenever, I mean, whenever
day,
it's the
to
first,
this day,
right.
To this day, there's some jeans that is, like... Even my mom be looking like...
Yo, it's a little too tight.
Jeans is tight, like...
I don't listen to old people, though. And my dad tried to call me out on that, too, son. Nah, my dad tried to call me out on that, too. Yo, the jeans I'm wearing right now, my dad tried to call me out on it, and that shit didn't phase me at all.
Yo.
Man.
Yo.
Yo, I don't. Yo, I don't. I don't.
Yo, this nigga is crazy, bro. Like, say, I don't listen to old people.
Yo, I'm dead ass, though. I'm dead ass. Yo, I don't listen to old people. Yo, I don't take.
Pay them no mind.
Yeah, I don't take it seriously. Like, my dad tried to call me out on the same jeans I'm wearing right now. He's like, yo, them jeans are skinny, man. And I'm like, yeah.
They're skinny jeans.
Like, and then I had to flip it because, like, I know he's like, a musician and you listen to rock and roll. Mm-hmm. So I was like, yo, they're like skinny jeans, bro. Like you acting like you never seen this shit before. He's probably wearing them when I was your age, yo. All is missing is a little rock chain, you know, the keychain for your wallet. Nah, that's all that's missing, though.
But people in like dumb type of days, like rock and roll age, they was wearing like spandex.
This nigga look at me like I'm wilding.
They were wearing spandex, bro. Like I'm on some wilding. Like zebra print,
yeah.
They was bugging on some different shit. Bro.
So what's your mom say?
Oh nah, she was just sometimes she'll look at the jeans and she'd be like, they too tight. Like, you sure, like, you going to wear those? She always say that. You sure you're going to wear those? They look tight. I'm like.
So what's up?
I tried them on. I know they tight.
So what's up, yo? Like, I wear what I want, man.
I tried them on. They're tight. Okay, I know.
Get defensive.
I'll see you later. And okay. I walk out.
Okay.
Walk out, like. Okay, man. Even, like, shorts, too. My mom be seeing me with shorts. Sometimes I wear shorts. That's like.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, man, I got shitted on that shit, too, man. Not by my mom, though, by my boys. My own boys, man.
That's crazy.
That hurts the most.
Well, that's expected.
That hurts the most. And most of the time, I'm on the other
hurt,
side.
It would hurt more if my mom come at me for that.
Your mom come at you for that?
It would hurt more for me if my mom come at me because sometimes I wear the shorts. I'd rather, like, my mom come at me for that. Your boys is expected. Those niggas are dicks.
Most of the time, I'm on the other end, bro. Like, most of the time, I'm the one. I'm the dick, yo. And yeah. Yo, let me tell
you. No, it's true. Because most of the time, I'm the dick.
I'm letting these niggas know, like, because, like, my boys, like, they take a long time to, like, update their clothes. Because they just used to, like, whatever they wear and shit. You know what I mean? Like, once you got a style, you got a style. Like, that's how you dress. So, like, I be telling these niggas, yo, y'all got to, like, fam, like, what is you wearing, bro? Like, you got to update, son. So every time I see something new, I be calling it out. Like, oh, my man got new Jordans, yo. You know what I mean?
You one of those.
Yeah. Like, I was like, yo, I see you, bro.
I hate
but
those
now,
niggas.
I know, yep. Like I said, I'm on the other end, bro. I'm on the other end, but check it. Yeah. Now, this year, all of a sudden, all these niggas is getting fresh now. Like, my man came, like, we hung out, and, like, I'm on my, like, street clothes shit because I thought we going, like, we're not going out, right? I'm just about to hang out, get some drinks or whatever. So I'm on my street clothes shit, like whatever I'm wearing right now. And my man comes up with like this like polo flower like shit going on with like these like green pants and like some Clarks on. And my man just walks up, sunglasses and all. I'm like, yo, yo, Suave Poppy, where you going, dog? Like, yo, we about to go to City Island, fam. I don't know where you about to, like, oh, yo, where's your ticket to Miami? Because I'm confused, yo. Like, I don't understand.
Nah, he trying to.
Yo, he was trying to flex, man. And then he looked at me like, nah, bro, you wrong. You in the wrong, son. I'm fly out here. Like, you out here look dressed. He said, I dress up like a kid.
He said, you dressed up as a kid?
Nah. I was like, dog. Oh, man. So, yeah, bro. Like, now I've been on the receiving end, son. That shit don't feel good.
Yeah, that's... To me...
I don't mind, though, because I know I'm fly. Like, I don't need... That's the confidence, nigga. Like, yeah. That's the confidence. Like, you have to be confident in what you wear. So, like, if you're not confident or comfortable in what you wear, then it's a problem, but...
You got to dress fly every day. That's how I look at it.
Exactly. Like, and there's levels to it, right? Like,
that's
like
how I look at it.
There's levels to that shit. So you got outfits where like you're fly but relaxed fly. Then you got like
fly, then there's the pop out fly, what I like to call it when you pop out.
See, only niggas who know that. You know what I mean? Yeah. Like, oh, okay.
There's levels for sure.
Okay. Y'all want that kind of? Okay. Mm-hmm. I got an outfit for that too.
Okay.
Where we going? Depending on where we go, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, niggas don't know. Right now, they finding out clothes and shit, and they just want to be wearing their boat outfits to a bar. I'm like, fam,
yeah.
It's not the right venue.
Yeah.
It's all good, though. It's all good. I'm glad these niggas just at least updated. I really don't, man. Well, one of my niggas, man, it was a little concerning, and then my man got fly with a bomber jacket one day, and I was like, ah. Now we can take pictures.
That's fucked up. Nah, that's fucked up. So he was the one taking pictures.
He was the one with the camera. He was the one with the phone. Yo, hold my phone, huh, y'all?
Yo.
I'm playing, yo. Shout out to Allison. You my nigga, you know that.
Yo.
And Raful, yo. You need to choose when to wear that flow shirt, dog. Can't be wearing that shirt all the time, yeah.
It's great.
And if that's your go-to, nigga, anyway.
Crazy.
But yeah, bro. I mean, niggas laughing though. If you want to end this out. Whew.
Yeah, man.
Episode 5, man.
Episode 5, this was fun, man.
We back. We back for sure.
Yeah, for sure.
You got oh yeah. Yeah, you got anything insightful, man? I'm in the laughing shit, so I even forgot that.
Yeah, I was in the joking mood.
I was gonna go straight to the yo, we out. Throw the track, I'm done.
We out of here.
Throw the track, I'm done, dog.
Nah, man. I'll keep it short. I ain't gonna give y'all niggas a whole Bible or anything. But the Nipsey Hussle song on DJ Mustard's album really touched my soul on that Friday morning. Touched my soul that, like, I was sending messages out to people that I love, you know, like, saying that they mean so much to me, you know what I mean? Even though, like, I always text it randomly, but that song made me realize that, like, you know, like, it motivated me to, like, keep...
Yeah, so I didn't get that message.
Yeah, bro.
I didn't get one, man. I just said, yo...
Oh, that's when I text you, like, yo, the Mustard's album.
I ain't getting no heartfelt joint. It's cool, though. I'm fucking up your joint. Wop.
Yeah, it's because he's the dick. I don't like the dicks.
This is true.
I don't like the dickhead people.
You're right, man. I'm a dickhead. I'm on a spiritual journey.
Fucking with you, man. I ain't gonna lie. That was mad pose, what I just said, though.
Yeah.
You said I don't like the dick.
Yeah.
That's crazy, bro.
Whoa.
That was crazy. I just called myself. Niggas is bugging.
Better late than never.
That out, right?
Maybe.
All right, whatever.
We call pause. I'll just edit the pause and put it in the front. Just put it that way.
Nah. Yeah, so it's just always checking on your loved ones, man. And make sure they're fine. Make sure they're doing great. Make sure their head is right. Make sure they're on track. On achieving their goals, make sure they're healthy, make sure their mental, ask how their mental health is. Mm-hmm. But before, you know, or even if you're going through something and you don't, before you want to talk to that person, just ask them first what's their mental space right now. You don't want to talk about your problems to somebody that got bigger, not bigger problems, but like going through shit themselves, so you gotta ask, like, what's their mental space right now before anything. But just make sure you're checking in on those people, man, because there's a lot of people out here that need help mentally. So, you know, just keep that in mind, and just always keep that positive energy around you. You know, you meet somebody that really, like, motivates you and supports you, keep that around, you know.
I just started, you know, this real kind of soul searching journey. I haven't, you know, the only book I really been reading was the philosophy book, and it's kind of showed me, like, how a lot of people over time, like, try to search for, like, what the meaning of truth is, like what's true in the world, like what we can rely on as true, and it's hard. I mean, the whole book is basically full of people's ideas that they thought were true until it was proven not true.
Yeah,
you know what I mean, by the next person. And and what intrigued me the most is that all of these philosophers, like, they just weren't that wasn't their thing. Like, they were, like, doctors or, like, you know, carpenters or whatever back in the day. And philosophy was just one thing that they would do other than that. And I just thought that was, like, inspiring because, you know, from when you're, like, a kid or whatever, you're asked what you want to do when you grow up, and you always assume it's just one thing. Like, off the rip, like, you just assume, like, it's just one thing. And I just want to tell everybody out there, like, yo, like, if you want to do something other than the thing that you're doing, don't let that, you know, don't let that hold you back. Don't think that you're able to only do one thing for the rest of your life. It's not true. Don't feel like you have to. I think the greatest people in this world are the ones that were doing multiple things in their lifetime. And one thing out of those multiple things stuck. And that's what they're known for.
Yeah.
But I think the greatest people do multiple shit. Shout out to Jay-Z, who's a billionaire now.
Shout out to Hov, bro.
But
much respect.
Yeah, like you know, they broke down his thing, and it was like all of this stuff that he does. Like, that all his money's invested in that he brought back. Like, it just teaches you, like, we're not meant to work a 9-to-5 job every day for the rest of our life. Like, we're meant to be greater than that. We're all meant to be greater than that. And if you got an idea, something you want to pursue on the side, whatever, I think you should do it. I think you should not think about it and just jump into it.
For sure.
The more you think about something, and I've learned this too, the more you think about something, the more you find excuses in your head to not do it. So the best thing to do is to just jump into it and figure it out on the way. But, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Other than that, man, I'm good.
Good.
Ready to throw this track in, man?
Yeah, you could throw that.
Yeah, you want me to do it? Do you want to tell the backstory on this before I introduce it? Because I know, like, you know, you're friends.
So, this is a not a close friend of mine, but she's a very good friend. She just dropped her single, and she's been dying to, like, drop the single so long, and she's been working in the studio hard, and she finally got her first single out. So, I'm going to play it here. This is actually going to be my first time listening to it as well. I haven't heard it yet, so.
Mm. Yeah. The song is called Letter to You by Amethyst. You know, if you listen to this, just know, you know, you're always welcome on the podcast. Oh, with anybody that we play on this podcast, y'all are all welcome to come up here and, you know, talk your stuff. We'd love to hear you. We love for anybody who watches this to come up if you want.
For sure.
And give us your opinions on things, because it's cool.
Yeah. So, letter to you.
Amethyst. Yeah.
All right, so I wrote this on 10/17 at 10:53 p.m. All right, so I'm some lame-ass nigga, you feel me? Because, you know, I know I did what I did, but I kind of wrote this letter, you know, trying to write it to, like, trying to send it to you that day, but I was like, let me just hold it for when it matters.
Lately I've been thinking about you, but I ain't trying to think about you, baby, and all the things you said you never do, but I've got you on my mind on a daily. You on your own now, go on your own now, stop trying to get me to stay. Put a smile on my face, but it drives me crazy. You running some game and you think it's gonna work. Gave you all of my time, then you gon' do me dirt. I was just trying to love you, trying to put you first, but you showed me the real boy, you was just. And all of the things we went through, and all of the texts I sent you, it really just fucks with my man. I'm done crying, I don't need you. And all of the things we went through, it gets kinda hard to forgive you. Apologizing's overdue, but I've been trying, I'm done crying, I don't need you. I really used to love it when you would call me, just to see how I'm doing, if I'm feeling lonely. You got all of these bitches thinking they could clone me, talking about how you miss me, how you want the old me. You on your own now, go on your own now, stop trying to get me to stay. Sitting here wondering now if you still want me. Do you still want me? You running some game and you think it's gonna work. Gave you all of my time, then you gon' do me dirt. I was just trying to love you, trying to put you first, but you showed me the real you, boy, it was just. And all of the things we went through,
live once again, cause like, cause I like what you do and how you carry yourself and obviously how beautiful you are. I know it's hard to believe me when I'm constantly doing corny shit like this. To sum this up, I feel like you always kept it real enough.